Paul, I think you kind of addressed it last night to a degree, but your first year in Oklahoma City, playing in the city, playing for this organization, you kind of like look back on it and zoom out. How do you think it went?
I thought it went real good. Obviously, it's the first year, so it was an adjustment. It was a new year for me, new things, a lot of new opportunities, new lessons to learn, new experiences. But I thought for our first year, we set the bar on a lot of good games that we played, a lot of good quality wins. I think we set the bar of what we could be. And then, you know, it's obviously it showed at times us just being together for our first year with the lapses and some of the losses that we've got this year. But as a whole, I had an amazing year here. The fans, the love, the energy, everything's been amazing here. And a lot to take with me, be happy about coming this summer.
What do you think this team can be?
This is a big decision ahead of you. It's not the first big decision you've had to make. What's your process like in terms of how you go about approaching a decision like your free agency?
First time being in this situation, so kind of just let the summer happen, kind of decompress, get away from just basketball in general for a little bit, just come back to it.
Do you kind of have a list of things that are most important to you that you're going to kind of try to check off first?
Absolutely.
So, Paul, you look at where you were a year ago and where you are now. What's the biggest difference in how you're feeling?
I still feel good. I feel good about, again, what we accomplished here, the relationships I built. I feel good about that last year, but I was always obviously traded. So, but going forward, I feel good of what we can accomplish here.
Paul, you mentioned the consistency issue a lot this year. You did it to start off. Now, do you feel like you have to think about it, how to improve it in a different way over the offseason if you do end up back here? Just like, do you feel like you have to approach it, considering it was still an issue late to the year, approach it differently?
I just think a lot of it stemmed from, trying to figure out chemistry, trying to figure out communication. I think you just go through all of that, trying to understand guys, trying to understand personality. I think all of that comes into play. I think the more you're around one another, the better those areas improve. So that's all it comes down to, us being able to talk through things. I think that'll limit the inconsistency and winning big games and to losing the games that we shouldn't. So that'll all play a role.
Was it tougher to find it than you thought it would be? Because that was a theme throughout the season that you guys talked about.
Absolutely. And I think it's only tough knowing everybody wants the same thing, just how you go about trying to pull it out of everybody, trying to communicate. So it was definitely tougher than I thought looking at what we had. But again, that can all change within a year. And the more you're around somebody, the more you're around people, the better understanding you get from one another.
And you say things like chemistry with Russ improve over the course of the season. You've been the lead dog before, and you have to work with another that has the ball in his hands a lot. How did you feel that worked out over time?
There was some highs, there were some lows. I thought ultimately we got a lot done. That was one of the biggest adjustments I thought myself coming into here, but I thought it was good. I thought it was areas to grow from, areas that we can improve on. But again, that it was a learning as much for me, a new experience for me. It was for him trying to figure out how to play with me. So I thought we both grew together, trying to get that chemistry.
Paul, as you head into this summer for yourself individually as a player, what's your, we haven't kind of had this experience with you before, what's your normal routine as you attack your work and your growth and development, and what do you try to improve upon each summer?
Well, I think just getting healthy, getting my body back healthy. A lot of nicks and bruises over the course of the season. That's first and foremost. Again, getting away from the game, whatever medically I need to do, address that this summer. But you know, then after that, after all of that is done, then it's going back to the gym, getting back into the lab, working on what I need to work on, watching film. I think just digesting all the areas that I felt were weak for me, were poor, that you know I can address. How I've dealt every off season, try to address the weak points in the season that I had. So that'll be the case again this summer.
What was your relationship with Billy Donovan like this year, and how did he assist you as far as your development?
It was really good. It was really good. We had a real good conversations. He played a big role in helping me get comfortable, helping me transition here. It was definitely an easier process having Jonathan by my side and talking with me. From when I first got here, having dinner at his place, he helped big time in that aspect.
Well, you mentioned medically. How are you in terms of your hip and your forearm, and are there things you might need to address in the offseason?
Yeah, I got a couple, a knee, the forearm, the hip. Those have been the biggest things, but I think kind of just everything, just healing. A lot of bumps, a lot of bruises. I feel like everybody has. But, you know, just being able to address it this summer will help.
As it's kind of been throughout Russell's career, criticism's kind of followed him. The way that he played last night's game, there's a lot of conversation. You took 43 shots, you're 16. How do you view that? Do you care at all about that sort of disparity?
No, I never, I've never cared. I try to play a game the right way and make the right plays. I've never been a guy that's been salty about the shots I'm getting. What shot somebody else is getting, that's never been who I've been. I just try to play the game the right way. The fact of the matter is, Russ got it going early. Russ had it going throughout the whole game. And you saw a competitor compete the hardest that he could. In honesty, you know, it was times where I had the ball where I should have been more aggressive. But just, I was mindful. He had the hot hand, he was going. So, you know, if anything, he should be the one pissed about the little shots that I took.
Paul, what was the biggest challenge for you this season, and how do you feel like you grew through that?
I think the biggest challenge was just trying to, you know, figure out how to be me. You know, the last 5-6 years of my career, being, you know, one of the go-to guys, or the go-to guy, trying to find that balance, you know, where I have other go-to guys on the team. I thought that was probably the hardest adjustment. It's getting out of the comfort zone a little bit. But I thought, you know, I did well with it on a game basis of trying to figure out how to be myself without taking away from others and playing within our system. That was definitely a hard adjustment.
Sports Radio is 107.7 The Franchise.